If you clicked on this video, chances are that you are a webtoon creator or a comic artist, in which case, I welcome you to the club. Even if you aren't, I can assure you that this video can be helpful in one way or another, if you like drawing, modeling, or just architecture or interior design. First of all, let me introduce myself. Hi, I'm Woglewu. I've been publishing stories on Webtoon for around 3 years. In that time span, I've completely finished one story, and after a year-long break, I recently started on another one. The most noteworthy difference between these two stories, aside from the general art glow-up, is that my first story, Stranded, didn't use any 3D backgrounds at all. Meanwhile, my new story, Even When the Sun Doesn't Shine, almost exclusively uses 3D backgrounds. So let's talk a bit about 3D backgrounds in general. Why would you want to use a 3D model instead of drawing it by hand? I'll give you a very simple answer. Because drawing it by hand takes too f***ing long. Publishing comics is mostly about consistency, and let's be real, a background is just that, a background. Yes, it can convey the setting and sometimes important information, but it's rarely the focus of a panel. 3D backgrounds are fast, and they are also much more consistent than those you draw by hand. Another benefit is that you can spin around the camera much more without having to worry about pulling your hair out in frustration because you have to draw the same background for the fifth time from another perspective. Maybe it's just my own laziness speaking, but 3D backgrounds are simply superior. But let's not pretend there aren't downsides. For example, if you want to use most 3D backgrounds, your art style has to line up with that of the background. That's part of the reason why I didn't use them for Stranded. The art style I was going for back then was simply too messy and unrefined to look good with the polished look of 3D models. Instead, I settled for drawing everything by hand, and trust me, I hated every second of it. So with all that in mind, when I decided to start my new story, I knew that 3D models were the way to go. I polished my art to be able to blend in with the background, but there's still one major problem left to deal with. There are no pre-made 3D models that look the way I want. In Even When the Sun Doesn't Shine, the main characters' houses and bedrooms are important locations for the story, and I can't just grab exactly what I need from Clip Studio's asset store or from other 3D websites. So what other choice do I have but to make it myself? I spent hours making both their houses and rooms, and now I'm here to share with you how I did it. No need to thank me, although if you really want to, I guess you could like this video or subscribe to my channel. I'd appreciate that. Anyways, let's jump into the tutorial. We'll be working with Blender, which is a free 3D software that you can download using the link in the description or through a quick Google search. If you're new to Blender, I recommend watching a few videos about the basics and then return here because unfortunately I don't have the time to cover them. I'll leave some links in the description for that too. So, we're in Blender and now we need to make the room or house or whatever background that we need. Your first thought might be to make a cube and start modeling from there, but no, that's not what we're doing here. I'm gonna teach you the secret to making a good looking room fast. It's free, it's quick, and it's easy. Go to Edit, Preferences, and then to the Add-ons. Here I want you to search for Archimesh and make sure it's toggled on. Now that you have Archimesh, you can get access to some really useful tools for making rooms and houses. That's because Archimesh is made for architectural use. But today, the weebs are taking it over. You'll find Archimesh and all its tools under the Create tab right here. After deleting everything in the scene, the first thing we want to do is to create the walls. You can change the direction, length, height, and thickness of the wall very easily. You can also decide if you want a baseboard or not, which I do recommend because it just looks more fancy, but it all depends on what you're trying to make. Of course, we need more than just one wall, so let's increase the number. Now you can change the length of each wall separately. Honestly, the possibilities are endless of what you can do here. Make whatever shaped room you want. Once you're satisfied, we can move on to adding doors and windows. Create either a door or a window, place it where you want it to go, and then go back to the room itself and click the auto hole button. This will automatically cut out the holes in the wall for you, making your life very easy. You can change the doors and windows to better fit the aesthetic you're going for, whether that be modern or maybe more rustic. Place some more things and voila! Just like that, you created your very own room. The best thing is that you can move everything around and then cut out new holes for it. It's a non-destructive workflow, so you can keep iterating until it's exactly how you want it to be. But those are just the basics. ArchiMesh comes with more useful things like stairs, columns, lamps, bookshelves, and even curtains. Just like the walls, windows, and doors, these have their own settings that you can play around with. This room right here is one of two that I made so far for my webtoon. As you can see, it has everything we talked about so far, but it's still very lackluster, don't you think? It's a far cry from being a proper bedroom like it's supposed to be. So where do we go from here? I'm sorry to say that from this point onward, you need to model most things yourself. But fear not, because I am here to tell you that it's really not that hard. If I can do it, so can you. Just like when drawing, modeling is all about simple shapes. A bed is essentially just a fat rectangle with a bevel modifier, and the legs are smaller rectangles that you can place easily with the array modifier. In other words, you only need to make one leg and then it gets duplicated. Furniture is probably the easiest thing to make in 3D, so don't give up until you've tried. The blanket on the bed can easily be made with a plane. Just give it some loop cuts and then go to the mattress and apply a collision in the physics tab. Go back to the blanket and start a fabric simulation. It will naturally fold itself over the bed like real fabric. Here's a more thorough tutorial on how to do this if you're interested. Personally, I like to go into sculpt mode after the simulation and move things around a bit to make it more natural, but that's not always necessary. I also like to apply the changes so that I don't accidentally press the spacebar and ruin everything after I got it to be perfect. The pillow is yet another rectangle that I subdivided and sculpted a bit on. It's all about simple shapes. With that, the bed is all done, and that was the only thing I probably modeled for this room. The rest I used ArchiMesh for. Now for the, in my opinion, less fun step of adding materials to everything. Honestly, flat colors will get you a long way, and it saves you the trouble of UV unwrapping your models. Apply flat colors to everything you can, but obviously some things need to have textures on them, like the floor and in this case the walls as well, since they're supposed to be made out of wood. The first step is to UV unwrap the object and make sure that the surface that needs texture is nice and flat. For the textures themselves, you can easily draw them in any drawing program you have, or you can find free materials with a quick Google search. I choose to draw them myself, or at least put them together myself, because otherwise the materials tend to look a bit too realistic if you just use something you find online. That's my personal opinion though, do whatever suits your taste. If you do choose to make the textures yourself, you really only need the base color. Make sure your image is a square in the power of 2. That means any of these measurements in pixels. In your material, press the little blob next to the base color and choose image texture. Then select the texture you made. You might have to readjust your UVs a bit to make everything as pretty as possible. But with that, all the basics are done. You have a room and it has textures. Now there are two options. You either add lights and render it in Blender, or if you have Clip Studio Paint, you can export it, set it up as a 3D material, and use it directly in Clip Studio. I've tried doing this, but it just didn't end up looking right. I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong, but it's just way too dark. If you can figure it out, this might be the best way, since that means you can use your model together with all the other things Clip Studio assets have to offer. You can also place your characters directly in the environment, which is very convenient. But like I said, I couldn't figure it out, so I just set up lights and render an image in Blender that I then paste into Clip Studio. Depending on the panel, I might render the background first, or I might draw the characters first. The benefit of rendering it in Blender is that you can easily change the lighting to match the time of day in your story. During the day, the sun is warm and yellow, but during the night, the main light can be more blue. Here are separate tutorials on how to set up lighting in Blender. With all the new knowledge you have, you can go on and make entire houses like I did. I was able to create the image I had in my mind, and now my story will be exactly as I've envisioned. The tools are there, you just need an idea and a bit of time and patience. Side note, when I was making this video, I realized that there's an option for adding paneling on the outside of the wall, which either wasn't there when I made my house, or I just didn't see it. I really went and painstakingly made it by hand when it could have been done with the press of a button. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned a thing or two. If you want to see for yourself what these 3D backgrounds can look like in action, please give my webtoon a try. I promise you won't be disappointed. The link is in the description. Anyway, that's it for now. Enjoy your new backgrounds, and I hope to see you next time.